many of us are used to having a card to access systems such as doors and elevators, but it doesn't always have to be this way anymore. Many of us are transitioning to using our smartphones, and that is something that Alfredo Neumann explained to us at Elatec. So hi Alfredo, great to see you here at Embedded World 2025. We're here at the Elatec stand, and you're well known for access control systems. Why don't you give us a brief introduction to Elatec?
Okay, yeah, Elatec started more than 35 years ago as a distributor for badges, for tags, RFID tags and badges. And now our main focus is the RFID readers itself. So we started as the main customers in our market was the print industry. So when it comes to private print, following print, so our customers are HP, Lexmark, Canon, Xerox, so the big global players. And for them it was quite important to have on one side, on the security side, a reliable system, quality of course, but maybe more important is to have international standards. So our products, or they are selling their products all around the globe, and we have in the meantime more than 110 different countries where our products are certified. Yeah. And with this experience, we moved the markets from the private print market to access control, general access control, to EV charging, machine authentication. So there also we have speaking to global players, and there what's important as well is they have different standards, so different transponder technologies. And we support with our readers, we support 60 different transponder technologies. Yeah. Wow. So if it's Legic, which is more in Central Europe, if it's MyFair, which is a global solution, or maybe HID, which is more the US and the Asian markets.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's what we developed over the last 20, 25 years. And that's our main focus.
Now, access control systems, I think most people are used to those in a hotel and RFID cards. Use one to get into their office. But I mean, it goes beyond just access control nowadays. Card readers are used for all sorts of technology. Where else are they used?
So I mean, if you look at an elevator, for example, so one of our biggest customers is a company, Schindler. So when you go to an elevator, there's behind, you present your card, behind there's a reader from Elatec. So the concept of Elatec is probably like you know Intel Inside some many years ago. So there's also the idea of Elatec inside. You don't see our products, but we are in a lot of, you're charging your recharger, your electric car. So you present your card to the system or to the charging station, and there's an Elatec reader behind that. Yeah, or PC single sign-on. Yeah, so that's the same. So there are more external readers which are connected via USB, so you see those, but a lot of areas that you can't see our products.
Okay, so what I'm showing here is our bestseller. In fact, this is where we started, a classical USB reader. It's not the most sexy one, I mean, from a design point of view, compared to this one. But this is functional. It's used in the print industry for the private print, the Follow Me print applications. And then when we expanded from the print industry into access control in other markets, we developed the embedded boards. So this is one example of an embedded board, which here is only USB connected. Here you have RS-485, RS-232. You have then also this SEM card, so you can upgrade the system to the high security technologies, you know. And there, everything is in there. So this is probably one of the most advanced integration boards. And here we have our latest product, which is a reader. It looks like an iPhone Slim. Compared to this one, I mean, quite a difference. And this is used mainly for access control for buildings.
Right.
Yeah. And there, in the meantime, all of them, they are combined as well with mobile technology. So they have integrated NFC, BLE. With our mobile credential, we just present it and you have access to the building. So nothing to do. So it's straightforward.
And so here I've got an RFID reader, mobile access, but also I could put a PIN code in as well.
Yeah, so it's based on this small module. This is the base technology with integrated in all the three. This is our platform in all the three models. And they have everything what you need. So there's 60 different technologies, you know, mobile as well. So everything integrated.
Now those cards are nice and convenient for people, or at least they were in the past, fitted into the wallet nicely, but they're also something you can lose. There's a risk of that. The thing that's sort of replacing that for a lot of people are their smartphones. They've always got their hands on those. Is that a way forward for being my way to access technology?
Yeah, I mean, that's a trend. And so we have our own mobile credential platform, which allows our customers to issue mobile credential in addition to the normal cards. Mm-hmm. So this is a platform which is very, very sophisticated. It's based on our own web-based solution, or is also available as an integration into existing system of our customers. Mm-hmm. And it's available for Apple, but also for Android systems.
Yep.
So here you see our idea of breaking down silos. So you see different use cases where an RFID reader is needed. If you look here, this is for electronic charging. Yeah. Then if you look here, this is the elevator. Yeah. So you have an RFID reader where you present your card. So these are locker systems. Yeah. Oh, you go on here. This is PC single sign-on. All of them, they have an RFID reader where you have to identify yourself. And with our technology, with our reader, it works in all these environments. There might be different card technologies as well. Here they might be using a MyFair card. Here they might be using a Elatec card. And with our readers, we can read all of them. Yeah. And this is machine identification. Yeah. So there, the operator of a machine, before he starts his shift, he has to identify. Yeah. So there are many different applications, and our readers are compatible either through USB or with embedded boards.
Yeah. Now, and people who want to use your technology and access it, I guess you have some sort of flexible development kits that allow them to match it to their application needs. What's on offer there?
Yeah, well, what's happening, as you mentioned, that the world is changing. There's the mobile phones, there's different technologies, like I mentioned, so 60 plus different technologies depending on the regions. And also for our customers, they also have changing requirements. So Elatec started as a hardware company, made in Germany products, but the difference we make now with our software. And our software development is a very powerful tool, which allows, if there are changing requirements from our customer side, so they download the latest version, they can do with remote updates, can update the readers in field. So it's security of investment, so that even something changing in the market, it's a general trend, or is it a legal requirement because maybe some regulation and standards norms are changing?
Yeah, yeah.
So we're complying with that. And with the software development kit is that tool which our partners are using on a daily basis.
As you say, the market's changing, the technology's changing over time.
Yeah.
What are OEM's biggest challenges, and how is Elatec helping them to overcome them?
Well, in fact, the biggest challenge is probably the world is getting more complex. Yeah, our customers are global players who are distributing their products all around the world. So this is a company like Schindler for elevators, this is Scheidt & Bachmann for parking systems, this is Axis in Sweden for intercom stations, you know.
Yep.
And they are RFID is a you need to certify the product to get it used. So it's based on radio frequency. And that's always changing. And what we have there, that we're always staying on top of what the changes and implement this so they can comply with the local requirements for the products they're selling in their markets. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's the main challenge, that we have to be flexible from hardware to software to services. Yeah. Yeah. So
now a trade fair like this is a great opportunity, not just to meet customers, but there's also lots of your partners here.
Yeah.
What
are
some of the interesting partners and the innovations that they're showing that you've seen?
Yeah. So what we're seeing here is, first, it's okay. We're very glad that we are represented here, either with directly integration partners or also major distributors who are representing our products. And what we've seen is in the HMI phase, so there's a 50.6 display, where the challenge is when it displays, you always have to see where to position the card. Yeah. So very often you see this sign for mobile, and people don't get it right. And we have now, one of our partners here, they integrated, developed a solution where you can position the card somewhere on the display, and it will recognize it. So this is one of the most, and there's a lot of development, big displays are getting bigger, it's more affordable,
and we're always on top of that. So.
Now, access technology, we've already spoken about the fact that mobile phones are probably going to be the preferred way of accessing and services and systems. How's the future going to look? What are we going to see in the next 5 to 10 years?
Well, that's a good point. I'm coming from the print industry, and when I started with them like 25 years ago, they said paper is out. Nobody's going to print. Everybody will be digital. Still, they're printing as much as before. And the same is with the card. Yeah, the card is there. People said, okay, everybody move into digital, but it's still we will both worlds coming together. And for us, most important, we're investing in brain capital. I think that's the most important part for us. I mean, we are based in Munich, so that's the center of Germany for IT, for technology. We have offices in the US, in China, in Singapore. And I think that's be close to the markets, you know, to the trends, and get the right people, which sometimes is a challenge, definitely. But we're trying hard, and to be on top of that is, get the right people and investing in R&D. And another point, which is also important, what we see more and more, that the companies, our customers, are using us, our external R&D department, because they have the RFID technology is very special, you know, and when they're speaking to their customers, to their big OEMs, I said, okay, what do you recommend? How should a future product look like? Yeah. They speak to us, and we give them recommendation. They involve us in the pre-design phase, in the prototyping phase, and that's something where we are their outsourced of the ID department, and that's something which we will invest more and more in that.
Yeah. Well, thanks for the overview of the access market and also the changes with using mobile phones, but also some of the maybe not changes of the future as well.
Yeah.
So it'd be fantastic and very interesting.
Okay, thank you very much. It was a pleasure.